So here it is, game number one, Harimoto to start it off. And he does, following his serve quickly.
The most improved shot of Tomokazu Harimoto, I would say, is his forehand. Gets it in there.
And a nice tight serve, good amounts of underspin there on that pendulum serve. Again, this is the first serve that most players learn when they get a new racket by a lesson with the coach. It's the most classic, yet it's used by the greatest in the game still. Nice save on that wide extended forehand reach there from Harimoto.
Yep, a less common way that you will see Harimoto try and keep a cushion there. An emergency shot, but there was so much pace coming in, just shielded it.
Good rotation on the backhand side as well.
They had a close game last time these two played. It was at the Cup Finals, Xingshan, in the same month that Tomokazu Harimoto beat Wang Chuqin and Fan Jindong at the World Team Championship semi-final.
So the crowd will be behind this man, no doubt about it, and this man being Wang Chuqin right here on screen. Took a little bit of time off after a racket toss a few years back, and it's never been the same. So much spin on this ball from under the table, still using full racket speed instead of for a speedy shot, for a spinny shot deep to the corner.
Greased it, nice dwell, great angle. Tempted Harimoto him, doing the sweep leg break dance move forehand.
Not the fastest shot in the world, but shallow. Again, a lot of spin here. You can have high racket speed and use it in different ways, as Harimoto just demonstrated.
Ooh, kicks up and Wang Chuqin top edges the ball long. We see the flick being used there, but if the serve's a little bit lower and it has a little bit more backspinny effect, the elbow comes higher and you might see both of these players using the Chiquita flick.
And there it is, the Chiquita or banana flick, where you come around the ball with side and top spin to get aggressive over the table. Wang Hao in the corner. Spent 27 months in a row at world number one.
Good position there on the push. Subtle changes. Like you say, the pendulum is used by Ma Long. Still, and he's used it throughout the entirety of his career.
And used out here by Wang Chuqin as well. Two in a row, but gets right in, follows the serve quickly. So when it's short to the forehand side and it's wide, he can give an even wider angle back. That said, at the second towel break here, Tomokazu Harimoto still up by two.
So much intention with the flick. Oomph. You can see there. It's less obvious, really, when you see it from that angle than when you see it from the side.
Right, a lot of different things to gain from different perspectives of the camera here. They do have a lot of cameras here, by the way, as I'm sure you've noticed, which is cool. It gives us a chance to experience the match in different ways. Look at Wang Chuqin there. Hope, another one of his nicknames. In China, anyway. Good spin on the parallel. Brings him within 1 point here. Wang Chuqin was down against a Japanese opponent in maybe, I would say arguably, the most important match of his life, at least thus far. 4-9 he was down and came back to win that game. And ultimately the match to save China. Oh. Clever idea with the soft block, but Wang Chuqin, the last to play a successful shot in this rally. The footwork getting him there and ready time and time again. Tomokazu fans in the crowd as well.
Amazing footwork, amazing recovery. The bat finish is so high above the head because he was from mid-distance and he wanted to play with more spin.
This is the first time in some time where Wang Chuqin felt like he was in a position to just be smooth and put it away. Almost felt effortless from him, and he's won 7 of the last 8 points. Coach Dong Qiming in the corner for Tomokazu Harimoto. Bottle challenge. Challenge accepted by Wang Chuqin. No bottle needed there. Bottles him up with 2 game points. Coming into the third towel break. First time I can recall seeing Wang Hao's face on the coaching bench.
Yeah.
Nice face.
Of course. One of the most important faces of Chinese table tennis. A 3-time Olympic finalist. I think still the most decorated Chinese player at the Olympic Games, Wang Hao. Definitely up there with Ma Long.
Tomokazu saving a game point after this massive momentum shift here. Wang Chuqin with a second serve and a chance to close out the game.
We've barely seen Harimoto being able to get his forehand into play.
I thought he had him with the soft.
Still barely at all being able to get his forehand counter or open up into play. Tomokazu Harimoto, the biggest risk you can take is to not take a risk at all.
My question for you is, how much of that do you think is intentional because he doesn't want to be caught on a long stroke? I mean, his backhand is so efficient inside the table. Maybe it's just a safety measure to get in position?
That's a lot to do with it, but he doesn't want to try and play the backhand from the middle or forehand too much because Wang Chuqin will find ways then to win it.
And so far he has. Wang Chuqin continuing, covering the forehand side. It's nice to see the whole Chinese contingency here watching. The forehand was there, but the ball didn't come down to allow us to really see it in action.
But he was hunting it, and that's the difference.
Funny, he's playing against Lionheart, but when asked what animal he would be, he said lion. That shot is untouchable. It comes in loaded with spin, and watch the closure on the racket.
Interesting guide flick, and the forearm comes through. The energy is just transferred forwards, and Harimoto could only watch. Even though it was a nice block, it feels like an escape when Wang Chuqin misses his forehand.
It almost appeared, I mean, this is complete speculation, maybe even absurd, but that's never stopped me before, that there was a fly or something that distracted in this moment. He was like, what? And or as if the ball had moved in the air. They turn off the air conditioning for this reason, so it wouldn't have been air conditioning affecting the ball. But that is the body language of someone saying the ball wasn't where it normally would be. It took a funny move in the air. Slow and spinny, but still, he stays right on top. Wang Chuqin with the closed racket out in front. Both of these games, I feel like, despite Tomokazu being the more vocal player, it feels like Wang Chuqin is dominating, but they're point for point.
There's nothing really in it. Just these key stages here. Any lapse of focus and you'll pay the price for it. Just a little bit more into the middle, that second backhand. Harimoto has a very physical forehand, quite a big stroke.
Yeah, he's definitely a physical guy. And it's working out for him. I mean, I've mentioned this many times, hitting the weight room from a young age. Tomokazu Harimoto, Very strong server, but here, Wang Chuqin shutting him down is winning two-thirds of the points on the receive.
If you serve into the backhand, if you have a motor, Wang Chuqin might flick cross table to your wide forehand, but he can just cover that. Well, most of the table with his backhand flick. A little bit more than Hanamoto can, actually. Wang Chuqin's push has come so quick, don't they? And his touches too, he comes into it like, almost like a jab, and somehow it manages to stay short a lot.
Right. I think a big part of that is he's got very little hesitation in his game. That's what makes him, one of the many things that makes him so dangerous. It's tough to catch him out of position, and it's tough to find an opening in his game or any holes, anything to exploit. In theory, if Wang Chuqin would step around a little bit more, he'd leave open the wide forehand corner, but he's so confident with the backhand.
Double bouncer. Gorgeous length on the serve. Wang Chuqin back in the driving seat.
Hand high, but it's a responsive blocking game for Tomokazu Harimoto. He talked about his forehand, and I think basically implied that he needs to take some risks. Get more behind the ball in the opening attack. Wang Chuqin trying to keep his head in the game, playing smart so far.
And by taking risks, I don't mean by the shots that Harimoto is going for. I mean when he steps around. The risks associated with how you're making space to play your shots. He's getting caught in some uncomfortable positions. Got to act a little bit quicker.
It's funny, the point before this, Wang Chuqin was the most vocal we've heard him in quite some time. For their generation, this could be considered the great rivalry. We're looking at world number two and world number three. Could also argue that neither player has reached their peak yet. 22-year-old serving to a 19-year-old. And man, does he serve it up with that third ball. Wang Chuqin with three game points here. Little hesitation. Looking for answers. A player who's been beating men in the top 100 in the world since he was 11 on the receive. Turns the corner, takes his chances, and saves a game point.
Location, location, rotation, rotation. Wow.
I didn't know you were into meditation.
Only a little bit. Not enough. Cool. I relax by watching table tennis like this.
Interesting, man. That's how I get my workout, my heart rate up. 8 serving 10. Big forehand twice in a row, this time inside the table. And look at the Harimoto fan club here. Jongbun, they call him. One more game point to go for Wang Chuqin. He did so well to escape the opening attack of Wang Chuqin. Down 0-2 in games, Tomokazu Harimoto to start it off.
Wow, the body to come up the back of that ball. Really, really impressive. It's hard to spin a ball that doesn't have a lot of backspin, especially if you're nervous. Maybe that's why Wang Chuqin floated the push at the end of last game. He knew Harimoto was trying to keep him off the attack.
Yeah, there is something to be said in terms of muscle memory and tension. When you start to tighten up, you don't flow the way that you're used to. It changes everything.
Sorry.
As he realized, I mean, it was ever so faint, but that's how polite he is. I mean, we've seen a lot of people celebrate points that have come off the top of the net in the last match. Ah, a little bit of GPS malfunction on this one. Destination clearly unknown on Lionheart's side. The precision there, Harimoto with the wrist back waits patiently to decide. That racket high in the forehand, a shorter stroke here. This is a good way to be in with a hot rally, the pace that Wang Chuqin's bringing.
That's what it takes. The block there was just good enough, but then look at that counter.
Had to shrug. Yeah, we saw him shrug that shoulder a little bit just to sort of get the racket up quickly. Speaking of quickly.
Yeah, going completely against the side on the reverse pendulum.
Funny, this serve a little bit higher to the backhand side. Testing the footwork, a lot of players would have had trouble with that. Qin Zhijian, the vice president now, after his promotion, Chinese Table Tennis Association, Li Xun sitting next to him, your favorite character on The Simpsons. Also a leader for the women of China, which if you've seen the world rankings anytime recently, I mean, it just speaks for itself. The records, the Chinese women, so dominant. Li Xun, a big part of that.
Didn't even drop a match at the World Team Champs.
They're trying to drop this serve just behind the net. Tomokazu Harimoto not able to stop the smiling and cheering of the Lionheart fans. Step around and an inside-out forehand. Really has to get low for this one, but this is the type of bravery you talked about.
Well, this is it. He can play those shots, but it's just when. It wasn't even a shocking receive that from Wang Chuqin.
This is just to tie it up. Remember, this is sort of a now-or-never game. He's never beaten Wang Chuqin in a singles match outside of a team's event. So best of seven here. If he goes down 0-3, well, he did have a similar comeback against Lin Gaoyuan.
Yep.
Down 0-3 to win four straight games in a row not too long ago.
Left, fight, or.
But we know Lin Gaoyuan has, you know, had quite a few matches where he's lost in positions you'd expect him to win. You don't really have that same association with Wang Chuqin. He seems to really clutch up when it really counts.
Yeah, that's what they need. Someone dependable to bring it back to China, the gold medals. A little bit off the top of the net there. Wang Chuqin having a fortunate rhythm break there, but takes his chances, gets a look at the ball still spinning there on the table. Wow. That was probably 10 seconds after a shot that I didn't even think of as a side spin ball in the first place. I guess it was the block. All thrown in on this one, yet Wang Chuqin. Good answer. That backhand receive makes it tough to talk about anything else in a moment like this, right out of a timeout, even with the fans watching. Jongbun, as they call him, Harimoto. That receive, so bold, so fast and low.
I think the biggest difference is the over-the-table threat with the forehand. Wang Chuqin has the better of the two forehands. He comes in for it. He hunts it just a little bit more than Harimoto. Harimoto likes to stay a little bit closer and try to dictate the direction of play with his backhand side. And there's only so much penetration you can have when you choose to do that. And that's why the most dominant players ever are forehand dominant players.
Interesting, interesting. It is getting down to crunch time here. Wang Chuqin just 2 points away from a 3-0 lead after defusing a timeout from the world number three.
Seven, 10.
And now three game points for Wang Chuqin, continuing to hold down the shutout here on the scoreboard. Backhand does it as smooth as can be. The world number two is one game away. You know he's not counting his unhatched eggs.
The cheers are being silenced right now. Wang Chuqin going about his business quietly. We know Hatamoto likes to get vocal to relax himself. But right now, not even given an opportunity to do so.
I thought he had him there with that clever backhand going two to the backhand corner. I thought the pattern was nice. Surely this must bother him, but Wang Chuqin had other plans.
How do you play that line from there? It's just miraculous.
Yeah, he's as bold as they come. So on a few occasions, he's been quite vocal. This is another one. I think it's his way of saying that was crucial. And domination in the last 16 points has won 12 of them, 75%. Ooh, Tomo turning for the backhand. Interesting. I think most memorably, Timo Boll against Dima to go to game seven at the China Open final. Couldn't get in on his serve and just said, you know what? I'm just going to give you something simple. It was basically that serve right there, and he was in a different position and into the rally. The weird thing to me, obviously it's impressive that Wang Chuqin is able to play these balls when Liu Guoliang is clapping like that and nodding his head the way he is. You know you've done something fairly exceptional. And I guess even by the fact that Tomo didn't even raise his racket for the last ball.
Hatamoto is more confident on his forehand really early on than he is actually in the rally. So maybe a way forward for Hatamoto could be to serve more with the backhand.
This is wild. Lionheart here just running around, claiming his territory all over the Infinity Arena. Only dropped one point here. And Hatamoto hasn't had much of an answer. It's a predator-prey game right now. And this time the answer gets into the rally. And when that expensive longer stroke forehand comes in, Wang Chuqin knows how to cash in on the time taken.
We love Hatamoto. The world of table tennis loves Hatamoto. What he brings, what he's given. But maybe it just takes a little bit more flair to beat the very top Chinese players. And Hatamoto is someone you don't really associate with flair.
An interesting point you bring up there about creativity, side spin, and something a little bit unusual. We have seen that from time to time over the years. 60% conversion rate on the serve for Wang Chuqin, almost double that of Tomokazu Hatamoto. Good job of moving in to catch this ball early. Tomokazu, one step in the right direction, but a very steep incline on the treadmill right now. Continuing towards that finish line. He has not crossed, doesn't have his toes there. But right now, the exchange rate between these two, it is looking very encouraging. For Wang Chuqin, who sets up 8 match points. We thought last game, and last game was the most one-sided game we had seen. After 2 narrow margin victories, Wang Hao, with guarded optimism, watches and waits as his student, Wang Chuqin, serves. Quite impressive to me. I thought Wang Chuqin thought he had done it. It looked like there was a pause after that first big shot, and he still got the next back ball into play.
Well, this is it. Didn't just put his bat there, actually followed through with it a little bit there, Hatamoto.
7 more match points here.
Legs, 10-3.
Ball back into play. The touch game. I think that's the most noise we've heard in frustration from Wang Chuqin. Just a subtle sort of, knows that He was baited a little bit there. Caught off guard with the opening, and now it serves back to Harimoto. But only the one. It's Wong Chu-Chin, a bow to the crowd. They